Hey, welcome back. So I'm really excited to start this new series, which will be to try and reproduce the tech from Spiderman Far From Home, the EDITH glasses. So not sure if you've guys seen the movie, but spoiler alert, essentially Tony Stark hands down his super smart AI glasses called EDITH, which stands for Even Dead, I'm the Hero. Classic Tony. So these glasses give Peter Parker access to all of Stark tech and also has smart augmented reality capability. So this series will try and push the boundaries of existing technologies and see how many features we can fit into this project. Just some acknowledgement to some really cool people who have worked on EDITH glasses are Hacksmith and Jay Laser Video. Links to the channels down below. So before we dive into the approach of this technology, let's check what has already been done. So the Hacksmith state that we can get close to EDITH glasses by using a product called Focals by North. So Focals are a very stylish smart glasses that let you manage your digital life without taking out your phone. While they do not provide augmented reality functionality, they provide a holographic display that shines directly into your retina. On top of that, they also provide support for Alexa and third-party apps. My opinion is that they are like a smartwatch, but in a spectacle form factor. JLaser Video has already two iterations of his EDITH smart glasses. The first iteration uses a transparent OLED display that is mounted onto the glasses. With a shoulder-mounted webcam, he's able to detect and recognize text from street signs. In iteration 2, he made some significant upgrades. He used a Raspberry Pi Zero with a Pi camera along with a mini HDMI display that can be hacked into any glass frame. The display is reflected off a plastic screen that allows the wearer to view the HDMI display. To add intelligence, the EDITH prototype takes pictures from the Pi camera and then uploads it to a Dropbox server where the Google image search is used for image classification. The issue that Jay Laser mentioned was that the process is really slow and with a lot of lag, but still really great progress in a short amount of time. Now I know I said he only has two iterations, but as I'm creating this video, he just released a third iteration of the EDITH glasses, which makes use of the AR glasses by Vuzix. The Vuzix Blade runs on open source Android, so anyone can develop apps for the glasses. You can use these glasses to view what a DJI drone is seeing via the app, or use Google Translate to do a live text translation from the camera. So what can we bring to the table in creating an EDITH glasses prototype? Well, with our powers and special sets of skills in AI computer vision and augmented reality, we can focus on AI and the UI. So I'm going to divide this project into several phases or video tutorials to cover certain aspects of the prototyping and development. So subscribe and click the bell icon to keep up to date with the project as it gets released. In this iteration, we're going to focus on the AI side of things. So we're going to start with face detection or face recognition. In this video, we're going to be able to get face detection working. So let's pretend for now that it is face recognition. If we detected a face, we would want to attach some information about the person that we've detected and recognized, just like how they did in Spider-Man, where they were able to identify various individuals on the bus. So just be aware that in this tutorial, I'm detecting a single person and assuming that that person is me. So I can bring up my bio in the AR view. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so this free YouTube series is just a small part of the full course. Some parts of the project development will only be available on my course called Ultimate AI CV Practitioners Pro, which is the complete training that teaches you everything that you need to know to become a pro AI developer in computer vision. So this includes object detection, object segmentation, pose estimation, as well as Android AI development. There will be a link down below in the description where you can enroll directly into the course, or if you want to learn more about AI CV, then there will also be a link to a free webinar explaining my 10 tips to becoming a pro AI practitioner. Okay, so let's get started with Project EDITH.
First up, there are a couple of paid assets that you're going to need for this project. For the UI, I used a Unity asset called Customizable Sci-Fi Holo Interface by Excelsior Assets.
Excelsior!
For that futuristic look, there's an optional asset called Holographic Effect, which is self-explanatory. And for the AI, you'll require OpenCV for Unity from Enoch Software, which contains the face detection and object detection APIs. There are direct links in the description down below to obtain these assets. So once you have these assets, create a new project. We'll call this phase 1, face detection, and you can import and download all the assets. Face detection. To get face detection working, we need to get the ResNet face detection example up and running. In Explorer, we need to copy this streaming assets folder under assets. I ran into quite a lot of errors because I didn't read the instructions. So make sure you do the step properly. You'll find the instructions over here in setup_dnn_module.pdf. Next, we need to download the ResNet face model called ResNet 10, 300x300 SSD iteration 140,000.cafe model, and store it in the streaming assets /dnn directory. Do the same for deploy.pro.txt and store it in the streaming assets /dnn directory. Do the same for deploy.pro.txt. But when you save it, make sure to rename it to deploy.pro.txt.txt to just pro.txt. Open up the example scene and ensure that you have a webcam connected to your PC. We can run it, and if all goes well, you should be able to see a nice green box around my face. But green boxes are so last decade. Let's spice it up by using Excelsior GUI that we have also imported. Go to our GitHub repository, Project EDITH, click download, open up and unzip, and let's import it into our project. Open up the scene and copy over the welcome screen and line it up with our canvas space. You may take a while to get this right, so try scaling and rotating the 3D objects until it aligns with the frame. Also, don't worry too much about it because we'll control it from a script. You'll find a script on my GitHub repo called Project EDITH. In the repo, you'll also find the GUI game object that contains the prefab holo GUI. Copy and paste the script. So essentially, what the script does is that it takes our game object and places it at the detected locations of the detected bounding boxes. You can also hide the boring green boxes for a much more immersive experience and commenting out these two lines. Now, chances are that you may not see your prefab holo GUI when you enter Unity Play Mode. You'll have to empirically calibrate your prefab location using these variables over here. Getting the location just right depends on the camera that you are using and the resolution that you set right over here. Mine is set to 720x480. So if all works well, you should be able to press play and be able to detect your face in real time. And this will give you that futuristic UI pop-up with some information on you. And that can be set right over here. There's also an entrance and exit animation that you can set based on a time delay. And that can be set right over here. Really cool, right? But simple. However, this is just phase 1 of Project EDITH's prototype. Let's quickly go through the planned phases of the project. If you'd like to add on your ideas to this project, you can comment down below so we can add features to make these glasses a reality. So phase 1, which we've just completed, is to get face detection up and running. Phase 2 is to take phase 1 a step further and to get multiple face recognition working with Unity and to be able to identify various faces. Phase 3, we want to scan the objects and for the AI to tell us what we are looking at. And this can be achieved with either a mobile net object detection or a TensorFlow image classifier. And then we have phase 4, where things become very interesting. We can try implementing voice commands similar to Google Assistant or Alexa to try and execute a drone strike. Just kidding. To scan for objects or to scan for faces. Phase 5, which is the IoT solution. This entails switching on and off our IoT devices and giving us visual feedback on our device if possible. Phase 6, which is quite exciting, which is our Android or Raspberry Pi solution. Basically, having all this power on a gaming PC is really nice, but eventually we need to make it mobile. This may be a bit of a challenge, especially since we're dealing with low power devices. However, we'll investigate if we can fit all this intelligence that we've built into the previous phases and see what features work and what features may require a compromise. And then we have phase 7, which is a VR solution or Unreal solution. Once we have it running on mobile devices, we can turn it into wearable tech. This may be in the form of Google Cardboard with a phone attached to it, or using a much more elegant form factor using the Unreal AR glasses, which may be released anytime now. So yeah, we have a lot of work to do, but let's make it happen. Comment down below if you'd like to share your ideas, and we'll implement them in upcoming phases.
Phase 1 to 4 will be free on YouTube, and phase 5 to 7 will be on my full course, Ultimate AI CV Practitioner Pro, which is a complete training that teaches you everything you need to know on becoming a pro AI developer in computer vision. So this is where we teach you object detection with QLO V3, object segmentation with Mars RCNN, and pose estimation with OpenPose, as well as Android development. There will be a link in the description below where you can enroll directly in the course, or if you want to learn more about AI CV, then there will also be a link to the webinar, which is free, explaining the top 10 tips on becoming a pro AI practitioner. Alright, so thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next lecture.